Seattle is walled off.
Walled off, yeah. So basically, we pick up 3 months later, and when people first found out, there was kind of like a mass exodus, but there's still some people who are in Seattle, and there's a wall, so there's people on the outside of the wall who now know that zombies exist. So all like people who are sick or dying are desperate to get into Seattle to save their lives. And then the people that are stuck in Seattle that fear for their lives because of zombieism are stuck there and are trying to get out to save their lives. So that is like when we enter this season, that's what's happening in the world around our main characters.
So who's the big villain?
Isn't that enough? Do you want a hat on a hat on a hat on a hat? No, I mean, that the politics of that is villainous, okay. I think, or just dramatic. I mean, we have Angus, as you guys were on the panel, so you said that, you want, okay, Angus is now, Blaine's dad is now a full-time employee. Thanks, guys. It's a TV show, not for cooking. Okay. So he's now a series regular. So he is going to be, he's now like a holy man, but he's not a force for good. And so you still have Blaine, who's now like, hello, I run the black market of Seattle now. And now he's like doing big business and having like even more power than he had at any other point. So we have Blaine, we have Angus, we have what the hell is Fillmore Graves up to, and then this other kind of like major political unrest. I think we have a lot going on. There are balls, there are evil balls in the air.
So Malcolm mentioned that each cop now has his own. Yeah, figured out that he wasn't selling this on his own. Are we going to see any sort of interaction with some of the other cops that are zombies?
I just hope there's one moment where someone just like goes up to him and is like, dude, solving murders with a zombie is so easy. like just like bust his balls on it. I also kind of hoped that there was like a pool of people that were like had a pool of like what they thought was going on between Liv and Clive. Like people thought they were dating, that they had like some other secret. And there's like that one person that was like, I had zombie partner. But I think there's going to be a lot of fun to be mined there and a lot of interesting things. And also, like, Liv kind of having to redefine, like, you know, she kind of had that niche covered, you know, and now it's like, oh, slightly a dime a dozen now.
Does that mean there won't be, like, a murder of the week that she has to
solve? No, there's still
a
murder of the week. Okay. Still a brain of the week, murder of the week. Some of the murders are zombie murders, so...
Are there any other brains that you guys could use besides the hockey one?
I'm so excited about the hockey one. The other one was a kind of like a bitchy boozy dowager, like a what's her name from Arrested Development? Lucille Bluth.
Yes.
Like Lucille Bluth. There is like a rom-com obsessed lady who I hope only wears like turtlenecks and has a really fabulous kitchen. You know? Only wears off-white and is, yeah. right? she sings into a hairbrush or cries, laugh cries. But and then there's there's like a diehard Seattle Seahawks fan that's like a face painting like diehard Seattle Seahawks fan. So those are some of the ones that are happening.
Will we see like the other partners team up with? Will there be like a brain of the week for the other partners too? Or is it just going to be Liv's brain?
I think like maybe there'll be like a something, but we don't have time for like a full. But there's definitely fun to be had there. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Where I kind of want to see Clive like getting like at the water cooler, then bemoaning the brains. You know, my partner. So yes. Oh, sorry. Oh, I'm good. Are you good? Did anyone have for you?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
Will other zombies be helping out with like even the same brain as her, like from the council? They're just.
I don't know. That is a very good question and a very interesting question, and I genuinely do not know the answer to it. I'm so sorry. Perhaps.